Welcome to the HB channel. My name is Hans Beekhuizen and in this show, a review of the Musical Fidelity V90 DAC. For some years now, the Musical Fidelity VDAC 2 has been my reference in set 3. Recently, Musical Fidelity replaced it with the V90 DAC, which, at least on the outside, looks like a big improvement. The VDAC 2's housing was a kind of DIY box, with the power input, all the audio inputs, and the input selector on one side, and the analog outputs on the opposite side. Rather inconvenient, since you either have all cables on the left and the right side, and no sight on the input switch, or you have the power cable, digital input cables, plus the input switch in full view. That input switch has two positions, USB or SPDIF Toslink. If you used SPDIF input on the RCA, you could not have any signal on the Toslink input as well. But then again, for its price, the sound quality was outstanding, so we learned to live with it. The new V90 DAC seems to take away all these inconveniences. The cabinet is still small, but now has a real front containing a power switch and an input switch. The latter offers three positions, async USB, SPDIF on RCA or Toslink, and a second Toslink input. On the rear, we see the two Toslink inputs, an SPDIF on RCA, the async USB input, and the analog outputs on RCA. It's not as cramped as the VDAC 2, and it doesn't look like a DIY box anymore. The electronics inside have changed less. Essentially, the same circuits are used, only the DA converter chip has changed from 24-bit to a 32-bit Burr Brown. That sounds great, but the V90 DAC has no digital inputs that accept 32-bit signals. The SPDIF input accepts up to 192 kHz sampling and 24-bit depth, while the optical and USB inputs are limited to 96 kHz and 24-bit. For the optical input, that's understandable, since affordable Toslink connectors have limited bandwidth. But why the USB receiver chip has not been replaced for a more recent type, I don't know. To more or less compensate for this, all input signals are upsampled to 192 kHz with, and there you have it, 32-bit depth. There's not much to report on using the V90 DAC. Just plug in the power adapter, connect the digital sources to the matching inputs, switch it on and select an input. Although the V90 DAC looks more adult than the VDAC 2, it's still a simple device. And that's fine, as long as it keeps the same benefits the VDAC 2 had. Good sound for relatively little money. That was the reason for Musical Fidelity boss Anthony Michelson to have his UK designs built in Taiwan. So it's time to listen. Obviously, I started in my €1600 set 3. The old VDAC 2 was already gone, so a direct A-B comparison was no option. But if there is a difference in sound between the two, it must be rather small. The VDAC 2 improved clearly when I replaced a switching power supply with a best of two worlds filtered linear power supply, so I connected the V90 DAC to the same power supply. That made a clear difference, even more than it did with the VDAC 2. The influence of the cheap switching power supplies varies depending on the design of the device it powers. Some housings, components and print designs are more sensitive to high frequency pollution these power supplies generate. It seems that the V90 DAC is more sensitive for it than the VDAC 2. That doesn't mean it's a bad converter, it's simply outstanding for the money. But adding a linear power supply brings it one notch further up. That makes the V90 DAC fantastic for set 3. With the V90 DAC, Musical Fidelity took an already very good VDAC 2, chose a more practical housing and changed the DA converter chip to one with a higher spec. That made it slightly more sensitive to the switching power supply it comes with, but makes it more easy to use. The power supply is, eventually at a later moment, easily replaceable for a linear type, and when you do, you'll end up with an affordable yet very relaxing, very good sounding DA converter for the money. It's ideal to bring low-end streamers, including the likes of Sonos and Squeezebox, up to the standard of an 800 to 2000 euro stereo set. The same goes for computers that I use as music players. That's why, up till the moment I find a better one for the same money, it's chosen to be the new DA converter in my reference set 3. Thank you for watching. You'll find a full review on the hbproject.com. If you have questions or remarks, leave them below this video in YouTube or on my Facebook page. You'll find the links below this video in YouTube. If you like this video, tell others about it and give it a thumbs up.